Hi everyone, welcome to our channel. My name is IJ.
Hi, I'm Yuchenna.
And I'm Dior.
And we're here to talk about our favorite show, Married at First Sight. It's season 14, episode 3, our recap review. Let's get to it. Okay, so I thought it was a great episode. Did you ladies think so too?
There was a lot to talk about.
And we're here to give you that little scoop to get your day going or your evening going. So two of the couples ended up finishing up their weddings. I thought they were great. So I thought we'd just start off with Noi and Steve.
Okay.
So tell me, what did you think about Steve when he was talking about his adventurous side? Did you think that really matched with Noi, or especially their ethnic background? Mm-hmm. You know,
He doesn't seem adventurous, but he says he has adventurous side, and he was funny. They were joking around at the altar. He brought
the ring pop.
Yeah, that was really cute.
Right.
And that made her like him even more, which I agree. I mean, personally, I might have liked the diamond ring better, but I'm just kidding. The lollipop ring was great. I would have loved that.
I loved how happy they were when they saw each other. They were smiles and giggles. I thought that was a great start to, you know, first seeing somebody and knowing that this is going to be my forever person, my potential forever person, and seeing the way that she was laughing and giggling. I love that. Mm-hmm. Now, their vows, I kind of forgot their vows, right?
They were lackluster, especially his.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't even remember their vows whatsoever that they said. So after they got married and the family was happy, everybody was clapping. Who was that young kid?
Her brother.
That was her brother. I could never see the name on there to see who that was. Yeah. That was her brother. Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Thank you for letting me know. For you guys that didn't know, that was her brother with the pink hair.
Right.
No, the
right.
pink hair was her sister.
Well, no, the orangish. You meant orange hair. The short orange hair.
Like, the girl.
No, that was her brother. He had the sash.
There was a girl with pink hair, I thought.
Yeah, I think that's her sister.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's her brother. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If anybody knows any different, just comment below, okay? So I thought it was really good. So I did have some issue with Steve during the show. Okay. And the issue I had was, how is he planning on taking care of her? And I think that's a concern of hers, especially coming from an ethnic family, especially an immigrant family that's come here to the United States. That's a major issue. So I wonder how they're going to navigate it. She says he seems like he's just in between jobs, but you know, I guess she was okay with it, going along with it. Thoughts?
She wasn't okay. Like, you could tell, but when she said, her mouth said she was okay.
Right.
Her face and her reaction did not say that she was okay. Yeah. But I'm sure she was probably like, well, he must have a potential to get a job.
Right. She does.
Would that match me with him? I don't think.
We all have potentials to get a job, but he didn't have one for 4 months. He went and took a trip instead of getting a job. I could see like 30 days, 2 months, but 4 months, even she was like, 4 months? That's a long time.
I'm hoping that that means that he feels like he can get a job very quickly and he had a lot of money saved. I hope those two are true.
Yeah, I was surprised when he was like, oh, I've been at this job for 4 years. And
that's not a long time.
4 years? And you're old. It's not like you're 26, you know? I was like, dude,
He got laid off. So he just, I guess, took that opportunity.
Look for another job.
Yeah. And so Dan, we had a late dinner because Mason had a b-ball game. So we were eating and watching TV. And he was like, that's kind of foul for them to match her up with someone who doesn't have a job. He's like, what were they thinking? I was like, I know.
Did they know right away, or did they find out later on?
They knew well enough to not match him.
I know they knew. I'm just trying to help out. I was watching that episode when he said he didn't have a job.
Maybe however much money he makes freelancing is like good. Like, maybe it's like what some people would make at a job. Let's hope that.
Let's hope.
He seems like a nice guy.
He seems like a really nice guy. I like both.
He's attractive.
Yeah.
They are really cute together.
Yeah.
And I like that he was just like, go with the flow. Like, she wanted to do her traditional, like, wear the traditional clothing.
Garb,
and
yeah.
He was just like, yeah,
go ahead. About it. Yeah. I would too.
Yeah, I would wear it too. I would wear it too. He says he wish she would have changed, because I'm sure he has traditions with his family too, because they're both from ethnic backgrounds. So I think it was great that she brought her tradition out. I think it's reminiscence of what happened last season.
Don't you even say it. Don't curse them. Don't curse
them. I take it out of the atmosphere. I wish I had some sage. But, you know, switching up the outfits. So let's just talk really quick. Do you guys, I don't even remember them taking their photos together. Did you?
They didn't show it.
Okay, because I was just like, did I miss a photo episode with them? So there, nothing must have happened there.
The fighting most, or bad or good.
Right. The most exciting thing I got to see about them, other than when they left to go to the hotel, the only thing I really truly recall is their dance.
Yeah, he likes to dance too.
He likes to dance too, right. Yeah. And the kiss that he gave her during the dance. I thought that was sweet. But other than that, their wedding was kind of okay.
They didn't even show them talking to each other's friends, right?
I do not recall seeing them. If they did, it was not anything worthwhile that caught my attention. They must
be a boring couple, because they're not showing.
Didn't write it down.
They're not showing hardly anything about their experiences together. Maybe, which is, I guess it's okay.
Yeah, it's okay because they're normal. Possibly because they're just normal and that there's no need to show anything, right?
Right, right, yeah.
Okay.
No news is good news sometimes, right?
Right, right, right. So let's talk about Alyssa and Chris.
I can't stand that.
Like, I don't know what to really say.
She's horrible.
There's no way they couldn't sense that when they were interviewing her. Like, she's just,
so obnoxious. She's entitled, and she is highly, like, she's bougie, and she thinks very highly of herself, higher than she should be thinking.
I want to say something really quick. I think that, and I'm going to talk about somebody's appearance. She should not be talking about him that way. He looks actually better than her. Take that makeup off, and I bet you there's going to be a little homie girl there. Her and her friends all are so irritating. It's like they've watched the Kardashians over and over again. I had to wake up to that.
I didn't see how they could be friends. Like, you know, the things that they were saying to him, like they were trying to give him like a warning about her.
Trying to give him a little bit of confidence when he knew all along that something was wrong. We knew something was wrong the minute she said, physical appearance is really important to me.
And she said that about a million times.
Yeah. And that's why she runs, but then she should go get neck surgery done, so that she can get rid of the double chin that's so bad.
So I was, she it is looks 5 like she's pounds weighing away from having a huge, if she gains an ounce, her back is gonna go like this.
Right. So she should go get trouble. That, like, you can get
laser
liposuction on there, and then a chin tuck, because we're gonna have a lot of excess skin, lady. I mean, like, she just really, I knew that. And when she said teeth are really important to me, which I understand, teeth is a person's smile, but when she started walking down that aisle and she saw him, her face just dropped. And I was just like, she didn't even think, how is it going to make him feel?
Well, it's not only that, it's like, you can get your teeth whitened. It's not that big of a deal.
And you can get braces.
His teeth aren't even bad. He has normal people's teeth.
Did she say something about his teeth?
Yeah, no.
She just said it, but remember, she said teeth are a make it or break it for her. Mm-hmm. And she says absolutely nobody with any snaggle tooth. So because he had snaggle tooth and his teeth were not pristine whitened.
He has snaggle tooth?
Yeah, he has snaggle tooth. Eugenia, what are you doing? Trying to pretend that you paid attention.
Sorry, that was me, like, incognito. No. So Mason was, this boy has done laundry a million times, and he still asks me, is this dark still white? And it's like a cream shirt. I was like, Mason, it's white. So I was going like this. Sorry.
So, but wait a second. So, you know, her friends point out that her teeth were white right before, you know, during, right when they were getting ready for the wedding. Mm-hmm. So when she saw him, she was upset. Then when he smiled at her, she looked at his teeth. And I know at that point, she's like, I'm done. And
she let him kiss her.
I was surprised. You know what? It's at the moment. She probably didn't want to make the people upset in the audience.
I don't think she was done at that point. Like, I think she was disappointed.
This was her during the whole entire time.
She's at the altar.
I think that she's an awkward person in terms of like being uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. And I think that she was not thrilled with how he looked. But
he was a nice looking man.
He's a nice looking man. But like her friend said, she likes bad boys. And right.
And probably that's why she's still lonely.
Exactly. That's exactly
true. Well, that's not the only reason. Her personality.
Yeah, that's a big reason. That's why the boy, you guys got mad at me when I said that's why the boyfriend called and said I was never coming back. It's because of her attitude, you know? Oh, I did it. Sorry, you were.
Yeah. Her boyfriend did call and say, you know, don't bother making dinner. I'm not coming back. And that's how he broke up with her.
And I can see it.
Yeah. Uh-huh. So let's just talk about when they were taking pictures.
Yeah. Well, you know what? She's not affectionate. Even her friends said that she's not affectionate.
I wanted the friends say that just for his sake. Just for his sake.
I don't think so. I think. I mean, she doesn't seem like a soft, warm person. She seems
cold to you. Mm. Well, she was so cold that she can even barely stand next to him during the pictures. I think her dislike of him and the fact that he's not her type just kept continuing to grow and grow and grow. So now she's looking for anything as to say why she doesn't like
him. His friends did him dirty.
They did.
You think so? I don't think so.
Oh, no, I, no, no, no.
I don't think so. I think they were giving her pointers.
No,
but those are things that you say. Like, no one wants to hear that their husband that they don't know is condescending.
Well, he said it's not condescending. It's that he wants to help you and he's a teacher.
Dan was sitting here and he was like, what are they doing? Why are they doing that? They're not being boys. They should be bigging him up, saying he's nice, he's great, he's this and that, instead of saying, giving all of his downfalls. You know, that's at a later date, like if there's an issue and she's, because you know they get together, the friends get together.
That's when
you say that, not first impression. That's crazy.
I can see
you have a little bit like, I mean, they could have said some of the tips without saying that he's condescending and that he'll make you, you know, like he thinks that he knows everything, you know, like they could have just said,
is that the way that
go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, I was gonna say they could have said the little statements like, oh, if he keeps talking, just change the subject, like without having to say why.
right. Yes.
But do you guys feel that his friends did that on purpose, or they were just trying to be helpful because it might be just like, we need to tell her now before.
I think they probably didn't realize her personality. So they probably thought they were being funny and that, you know, cause like some women are just like, they didn't know her personality. So they didn't know that she was going to take it all the way left field.
Right. So I just want to step back a little bit. This just shows you how awkward their relationship seems to be. Ooh, bless you. God bless you.
COVID. No, just kidding.
So do you think that, okay, step back. After when they got married and they, you know how the couples meet and talk for a little bit. Did you see how awkward it was when they were drinking their champagne?
Well, they just met. So
everybody else just met.
Tina and
Olajuwon were crazy awkward.
Get his name right, poor boy.
You think so? I think Tina and Olajuwon, they were talking and so forth.
That last week's episode, after they first got married, she wasn't saying anything. He just kept talking and talking and talking. She was very awkward and silent. Mm-hmm. And
there was silent moments.
Because he was so excited. He was so excited, you know.
Well, they still had an awkward interaction. So okay, theirs wasn't the only one.
But, you know, theirs was silently awkward.
But I mean, that's okay, because you're just getting, you're just meeting. And it lasted for like a few seconds. And then they started talking about, you know, things about each of themselves, which is fine. Like, honestly, there shouldn't be an awkward moment because you guys don't know anything.
Each other. They're just like small talk.
But one thing that I think that he should have waited on was telling him the golf about frisbee.
About the what?
Golf frisbee.
Yeah. I was just like, if you don't shut that mess up, shut it up.
It's like, I'm the vice president.
He might as well have been saying, I'm the vice president of the Dungeons and Dragons Club. It was that bad.
I know. I was just like, this.
I was surprised. How she was reacting. Like, I was like, oh, it looks like she's giving it a chance. She said she would not continue if, you know, anything was wrong. So I agree, I give her that point. His friends, you know, right. I thought she was doing as good as we could expect from her.
Okay, I give that point, yes.
Thus far, we can't compare her to everybody else because she's not everybody else. But for her, I thought she did okay. Like, she seemed like she was going with the flow a little bit.
Yeah. Right. I wonder how her friends, I wonder how her and her friends interact, because isn't it weird? She's so introverted. And her friends seem like fun, loving, and happy people, you know. So I wonder if you have to drag her around to everything and make
her do what she wants to do because she's has such a like a negative attitude. I don't know.
Right.
Before the wedding, like, her friends are like, just give him a chance, and like they knew right away. So you could tell that she's just really particular, and that's probably why none of her relationships work out.
I was listening to the TV show, but I missed the complete interaction with the mom, with her mom, and him asking, "Does she like me?"
The what mother was like, say? She said you were very nice. she said that she liked you.
Oh, yeah.
It was so awkward.
So what does that tell you guys? She was not giving him vibes of acceptance. She's very judgmental, is what it's saying.
And she's probably like that with everyone who she doesn't think is perfect or meets her standards. You know.
Do you know the disappointment he must feel inside?
Well, he doesn't know yet. Like, the whole time he was
He
didn't know. He was having a fantastic time. He was in cloud nine until she came out of that room and told him that, and very like obscure, like, there's something you said that doesn't sit well with me.
Okay, I have a question about that, you guys.
Tell me what you said.
Yeah.
Right?
But did they cut it out and we didn't get to see that point?
I don't think she said there's something you said. She said
something was said. Something was said.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But why wouldn't she tell him, and why wouldn't he ask? Right?
He did ask. He said, is there anything you want to ask me? Like, to clear anything up, anything you want to ask me?
He didn't press it, probably because he thought, remember the mom and them said, just leave her alone. If she's upset about something, just leave it alone. Let her vent, let her be upset, and then come back to it later. So he did exactly what they had said. Because if it was me, I'd be like, what was said? Tell me now. What is it?
Mm-hmm.
No. Mm-hmm. So, okay. Anything else about that couple you want to talk about? I'm upset that she didn't want to sleep with him. I mean, just lay in the bed.
Wait, did she say that?
I saw it in the previews, but I didn't hear that.
Okay, so we didn't hear that. Okay, so they did get to sleep in the same bed together or next
week? We don't know. They never got to the room.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I hope he didn't sleep in a chair.
In the room. Well, you know, if he's a gentleman. But
her friends had already told him that she probably wouldn't want to sleep with him. Sleep beside him.
Right.
We're adults here, people. We're adults. This is something you signed up for.
Yeah, I agree.
Mm-hmm. And you've watched the show several times, so you know we sleep in the same bed.
Right. Mm-hmm. Wow. And if she was super attracted to him, she'd be sleeping in the same bed.
Girl. They'd be having a great conversation. Her head would have been on his shoulder during the pictures. You know? Yeah, right. She would have been, you guys were all like, it's because she's like off.
I mean, office. I don't know if her head would have been on the shoulders. I mean, that would be hard for me to do with someone who I just met.
And you're taking your wedding pictures.
You don't see people doing that. I don't see any other couple that was doing that. They're like this.
Lazwan picked her up, his wife up. He was all kissing her and so forth, you know? No, it's just that she's standoffish because she's not attracted to him and she's upset. If it was somebody that she was attracted to, she'd have been smiling walking down that aisle.
She doesn't give me that. Like, she doesn't give me cheerful, bubbly, no matter how attracted she is to someone.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So,
but I did feel horrible for him at the end when she said that to him and he had no idea.
What was her last words when she was walking away? Because I thought they were going to sleep in separate rooms, but what did she say? I'm going to the room, and he just sat there.
I don't know, but she didn't say I don't want to be in a different room.
Okay,
so she didn't say I want another hotel room. She didn't say that.
Okay, we did see in the previews that they were surfboarding and having fun, so maybe things changed up a little bit. I don't know. Mm-hmm. And she said, you know, maybe I just needed to loosen up and have some fun. So
yeah.
So do you guys want to talk about Katina and Olajuwon?
Katrina and Elijah.
It's Katrina.
He was calling him Katina. Elijah.
Katina.
He called her Katrina.
And the mother was like, no.
She called him Elijah. Or I was like, maybe he told her that was the shortened name.
Yeah.
Elijah one.
So Elijah, I was surprised that his mom is Irish and his dad is Nigerian.
Yeah. Remember the basketball player? I think it's Hakeem Olajuwon.
Yeah, I remember him.
Yeah. So I knew that it was like an African name. I didn't know it was.
I just didn't know it was Nigerian. Yeah. So we start off with their photos. Like, I think he couldn't get enough of her. Mm. He could not keep his lips off of her. I mean, I love seeing beautiful black juicy lips just kissing, but my God, he was just loving her. I thought that was
so excited.
Right. What happened to the no sex thing that he was talking about? Wasn't he the one that was saying no sex?
I think she threw that at the door too, because she also told her friends that she wasn't going to have sex with him. She said she's going to try to hold out for a month. And I wouldn't be surprised if they're like, well, we consummated the marriage.
I know. Let's hope they don't, because that almost never works out. Hold it off a little bit longer.
Right.
I don't think they're going to work out anyways. But
because why?
I think he's too immature, you know, but who knows? It might be her based on the previews. You know, we don't know, you know, but I think because she's so beautiful, he is really into her like crazy.
I think his history and like her, you know, his attraction to her is going to make him insecure. At least that's what I got from the previews.
Mm, that's a good point.
What I got from watching this episode and watching those two is that, of course, he thinks that she's ultra sexy, especially with those tattoos on that one shoulder. It does look great on her. I'm surprised because I would have never thought somebody that speaks like her and acts like her would have those type of tattoos on her shoulders, but they are beautiful. Mm-hmm. But watching them, my fear is that he's going back into his old ways of wooing the woman and, you know, and he's ready to have sex, and then that excitement is going to die off, and then what's left? They haven't become friends. They haven't really made a connection mentally, spiritually, and I'm afraid that they're going to move so quickly that things die off and they both go on their own separate ways. That's what my fear is, and I think that's my fear for a lot of the couples, because it feels like some of them are bringing baggage, and a lot of them are bringing baggage.
They all have baggage. They all had rough childhoods, you know, rough family histories. And many, there's a lot of, most couples I think have that. So they just have to
everyone
be.
Everyone has their own. Yeah. They bring it to a relationship.
Right.
You had time to deal with it before you got married, whereas they're just getting all of it at one time.
Right.
Yeah.
So what about his friends? Now, his friends weren't that nice.
Well, they weren't as bad as the other guy's friends. They were actually okay.
You think so?
Yeah, I think they tried to warn her subtly without really scaring her.
Mm-hmm. Well, they were like, he's going to try to mold you.
Except for that part. That was the brother. That was just
I was going to say the brother was like, he's like a bigger guy. Did y'all say he was married?
He's married.
Mm-hmm. Well, he must not be having a good marriage. I don't know. Because even when he was getting ready for the wedding, today, it's just like, I don't know. It's like he has a negative.
I don't think it's towards marriage. I think it's kind of towards Olajuwon. I think there might be some jealousy there.
Could be. I was going to say, I wonder if the guys were looking at her and thinking, damn, why'd he get her? I could have had her.
I don't think so.
I think she was
pretty. It's true that Olajuwon has pulled some very pretty girls. You know, I don't think
he's that great looking, but okay.
He's good looking. He has a great body.
He's so nice that he pulls women in, especially with his personality too. Yeah. I won't be surprised if somebody called him Isaac. Hey, Isaac, when they were out to dinner.
That'd be great. That'd be fantastic.
I would love to see that episode. But so you guys feel that his family was okay, and his family and friends, what they were saying and warning her about was fine compared to Chris's family and so forth.
Yeah, I didn't think it was that bad.
Okay.
Again, I think it's like who you're speaking to. If Chris's family, if the same things were said to Katina, I don't think she would have went and said she couldn't be married to him. Because, you know, like, you haven't even met this person. You're just getting this from people. Yes, they're his friends, but you know, like, get to know him for yourself. I mean, definitely keep those things in the back of your head, but don't waste the end of your marriage on something someone said.
Mm-hmm. Even the producer was like, when she was crying to him about what the friend said, the producer's like, have you seen him, act like that tonight? And she said,
in the elevator, he said, I'm just a side piece.
But that's not being...
It was an obvious accident. It was a joke. He said he was the side piece. Yeah. He was her side piece. I just didn't get what was so bad about that.
I think he was just... I don't know. She just wasn't feeling it.
Right. So what do you guys think about Olajuwon's dance?
He's a mixture.
What?
He's immature. He was acting like he was at a strip joint.
You missed that? Lifting his shirt and grinding on her.
It was too much.
Family and friends.
The first dance?
Yeah.
No, I think it's when he pulls off the garter and she was there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, I know some people, do things for that part, but... Maybe when you don't know the family, you shouldn't do that.
It was so graphic. I was like, is he at a strip bar? Because, I mean, it was like a straight up strip dance. I was like, wow. So that didn't go off too good neither. But I don't think that nothing much happened with Jasmine and Michael.
There was one thing that happened with the Olajuwon, which I thought was probably the funniest moment in the whole show. When he was talking to the mother. And he was going on and on. Did you see that part, Dion?
Oh, yes.
And then she was like, wow, is that a duck over there? And then she went around and looked, and she got up and
went, no, I missed that part.
I was like, the oldest trick in the book. I cracked up.
But you know what? Now we know why he talked. Why? Like, I felt like during this wedding, he was all over the place. He has ADHD.
He said that last episode.
Okay, yeah, but I didn't really hear it till this time when he was talking to the mom. I was like, no wonder you're talking a mile a minute and you can't really, he's talking about this subject and that subject and that subject. And I was like, wow, can you imagine sitting through that?
That's why she played that trick.
I had one more thing to say about him. When they were in the bedroom and he jumped on the bed, did anyone else notice that his shorts were dirty? His
body? Yes! His underwear was
What? No. I'm
like, oh, he had like stains. Two big stains on his
on the side of his underwear. I was like, damn, they couldn't cut that out. That's
wait a second. No, if it's on the side, it wasn't down the back butt, Eric.
No, we know that, IJ.
Okay, but it was on the side. Are you sure it was dirty and not just like his suit rubbed on it?
No, it was like an orangish stain on his blue boxers. It was two stains. And I watched it twice because I was like, is my TV having some color?
They should have called this episode The Stain.
Time is ticking. So
I know. I didn't have much to talk about Mark and Lindsay. Did you guys have much to talk about Mark and Lindsay other than the families?
Mark hit it right on the head with Lindsay. He has her down. He knows who she is. Mm-hmm. And I think it's going to be
a
challenge for him.
It's going to be a roller coaster.
Exhausting. She is so exhausting. I just can't. Like, I watched the episode of the after party that she was on, and I was like, I could not be on the show with her. Wow. I would have strangled her. She just talks all over the place. And she's rude, too, kind of. Like, I don't know. I don't know
how. So why did they put those two together? Because he's such.
Well, remember, you can't see the whole person in an interview. So if you're basing just on that interview and the first episode that we saw with her and those like pre-screenings of get to know the person, she didn't seem this crazy.
Well, you know, she had alcohol.
But I think even without alcohol, I think she's slightly off, and she can't see herself as she really is. She has like a totally different. Opinion of herself. You know,
well, Lindsay, you're going to get to see yourself
on TV. Yeah, yes, after she watches it.
Because you'll see how you're behaving. My God. I did like the part that Mark did talk to the father, Lindsay's father and brother, and they welcomed him to the family because he doesn't have any.
You what? Yeah.
She's all yours.
Yeah, I think that's how they were feeling.
They were all too eager to say, yeah, don't back out of it.
No
take backs. No take backs.
Okay. What about Jasmine and Michael? Anything?
Oh, I love them. Like, let's hope that they don't disappoint them, us, you know?
They're so cute. She's attracted to him. Like,
his personality is so cute. He's so like chill and laid back and seems comfortable.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I love his sisters.
Yeah, they welcome her in the family by giving her a pin.
Yeah, with the mother. Yeah. So I'm happy for Jasmine and Michael. We'll see what happens with them. I'm happy that Mark is able to read Lindsay. I just do think that it's a lot for him. My God.
I wish they would have paired him up with someone else.
Me too. I'm sorry. Me too. I don't want them to be together. I feel like she needs to go to counseling before she comes into this marriage.
She's therapies.
Right. Yeah. Right.
All of their first nights, like it seemed like, you know, it went well when they got
into
the
room. Mark and Lindsay?
To be comfortable. Huh?
Did we see Mark and Lindsay in bed? Yeah. Okay. I don't remember seeing them in bed.
Yeah, everyone seemed comfortable with one another. The men helped them get undressed. Mm-hmm. You know, we saw Olajuwon and Katina make out. They were the only ones that were like,
they're the only ones that made out. Yeah.
So it was a good episode. It was really good. So I think next week it should be another good episode. They get to go on their honeymoon.
So we get to see them a little more in their element.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah. Honeymoon is always fun. That's my favorite part.
Yeah.
Is the honeymoon. Mm-hmm. And they get to really meet each other and see each other's significant other. So
And then they're with all the other couples. So
Right. I just know
of being with them alone for like a whole weekend or
Right. I do hope that though that Alyssa gives Chris an opportunity. And
they at least made it to the honeymoon together. I mean, I didn't see him, but I saw her. I did see him.
Yeah. I think it's just gonna be a struggle for him. Like, mm-hmm. and hopefully he can win her over. Who knows?
Yeah. Well, ladies, it is the end. We will be back on Friday with part two of what is it called again?
Ready to Love.
Ready to Love.
Too.
Yeah.
And
ladies who live Atlanta. Yeah. So make sure you tune in Friday to see us. Mm-hmm. So I want to make sure that Dior, take it away.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
All right.
Did it in the wrong order.
You know, we got to start saying that at the beginning of our show before people log off.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
All right, bye, everyone.
Oh, I almost.